What's up, guys? Leopold the Brave here, and wow, that is probably the most clickbaity title and thumbnail I have ever used in a video before. But don't worry, there's an actual discussion here. It's not just about Goku versus Superman. This is technically about the final decision in versus debates, claiming to have the final answer to a battle or the end-all conclusion. But trust me, no one has the final decision to any battle at all. There's just way too many possibilities of what could happen with a certain matchup. In the beginning of every main series universes video, I have a disclaimer at the beginning that basically says, do not take this video as absolute fact. Any matchup could end with any outcome, as the rules and research differ with any individual. And this is true! It's not just some mumbo jumbo I made up to try and soften the butthurt whenever people get angry about their character losing. Take Batman, for example. Batman loses a lot of fights. Batman is actually not really that tough. Batman's main strength lies from prep time, since he's a detective and he likes to figure stuff out, so giving Batman prep time and not giving him prep time makes all the difference. And this is also true when it comes to finding out how strong a character is. Some people like to believe in scaling, some people don't. Some people like to believe statements, some people don't. I personally believe statements if they're repeated consistently and are part of the main lore, kinda like the planet level stuff in Tekken. But some can choose not to take statements and only go with visual feats, which is okay. I don't have the final say in how powerful Tekken is, Screw Attack doesn't have the final say in how powerful Superman is, Seth the Programmer does not have the final say in how powerful Goku is. It 100% depends on the rules and circumstances you give the battle. Like, let's say, Superman versus SpongeBob of all things. And SpongeBob could win if the rules were set for him to. For example, let's say, sizes equalized, they're both underwater, and SpongeBob gets a kryptonite gun that fires at 60 septillion times the speed of light. Superman wouldn't be fast enough to dodge the bullet, and it's kryptonite. He'd get shot and lose. You can't prove me wrong unless you change the rules and circumstances.
But Leo, if the rules and circumstances are set to benefit one character, then how are you supposed to debate? It's a versus debate.
Well, just like you can find an answer in any circumstances, you can also find flaws in any circumstance. Like for an example, let's say someone doesn't believe in scaling, and yet they use scaling for one character and not for the other, and then have that character that they scaled win. You just have to be able to point that stuff out and argue properly. And think about it, if there's a final decision to a debate, then how come it can still be debated? Example being Goku vs. Superman 2 from Screw Attack, or the constant Goku and Superman related videos Seth keeps making. And same goes for me with Ryu vs. Jin. I made a Ryu vs. Jin video, Animation Rewind made a couple, Diphenoid, I think I'm pronouncing his name right, just recently made one. And while Jin did end up winning all of those, they did have different rules and different stats for the characters depending on those rules. So just remember, if it can be debated, there's no final answer, and everything in Versus is debatable. Oh, and one more thing. If you think this video was a way for me to chicken out of doing Goku vs. Superman, you'd be dead wrong. I'm going to get to it. Every Versus debater should tackle it at least once.